I guess that's sound one. I was gonna get that train over there, but I missed the horn. Going to the store to get some Cocoa Krispies. Hell, you can chop it up and use whatever part of that is any sound you want. Let's face a fact.
Okay. Alright, hey, good for good. Another car ride video, just like the old days.
Start this puppy up. The battery has been dying left and right in this car lately. They had to replace it. It was a new one.
Oh, shit. So I'm tired. I didn't sleep good.
Loud dogs, loud people.
My neck was hurting so bad since it's been almost a year since my neck break. Shut up.
Safety fucking cars. Beeping.
It's been a year since my neck break and I've been doing okay at the job. It hurt sometimes, but last night it was so bad, I was thinking I might have to quit soon. I still need a few more weeks of work, though, if I can get it. But my shoulder was going numb, and I couldn't even lift up, like, cups. I was like, oh! It sucked. You know, let's go, people.
You know, the radio's all screwed up, and that same people are the ones that
screwed up the battery in the first place.
Because of that.
For some reason, you have to fiddle with the light thing all the time, or the battery drains. You have to get it perfectly in the right millimeter setting, or you're dead, and your battery's dead overnight.
So, let's go to the store and get some chocolate Cocoa Krispies with the generic brand called Mom's Best. But it's good, and it's cheaper. And, it's, you know, they're Cocoa Krispies, Rice Krispies, chocolate flavor. And I get a couple gallons of milk. The sheep up here are nice. They talk to you when you go by them. Too tired to do any video editing.
That's for sure.
Well, they found some food to eat. They've eaten almost that whole field down. It was like 2 foot tall grass. Check out the scenery for you from behind.
This is my Saturday night, as it were.
On this fine Wednesday evening.
Somebody ate the last of the Cocoa Krispies, and I
need some Cocoa Krispies.
Well, hey guys, I don't want to go into depth about this too long, but
it's been real. Yeah, let's go to the store to get Cocoa Krispies because my mom tends to eat them all, and then I get home from work like midnight or 1 a.m. and I want some Cocoa Krispies and they're gone. I have a note saying, sorry, I ate your Cocoa Krispies. I'll get some more. It's not the fact that I have to eat more Cocoa Krispies that doesn't bother me, it's the fact there's none home. There's none left when I get home tired after, you know, busting my ass at a shitty minimum wage job. Same thing with the chocolate chip mint ice cream. You know, hey, that's what you get when you live in free rent. It's a rinky dink town. Your mom stays at her house all day and you're staying there. But, yeah, so hey. Got some skeeter bites going on the legs, too. You know how some people don't get mosquito bites, some people do. I'm one of the dudes. If my friends have 2 or 3, I'll have about 20. But, yeah, okay, hey, I already said that. And, I already wanted to. But, yeah, okay, yeah. Alright.
together and load up sounds, and then you remix them and make your own, like, kind of music out of the stuff they put up, or video, or whatever. Fly on Wall Fiesta, that's what I'm talking about. It's insane. And also sound. Yeah, I know, I said that my neck hurt, okay? And it did, but it's doing better. Check guts and good stuff. Now here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna open the car, put stuff away. Shopping carts really know how to travel through the sound waves, huh? Just irritate your pulsating, tired brain. Ugh. Next weekend's the busiest weekend in town. The festival, carnival, all that stuff. So I'm hoping my neck rests up before I go back to that job. Let's see here. We can check a receipt later. We don't need to put the bureau through that night when we're checking it in or something. Well, covered, dude. It's been thunderstorm season for a couple weeks. Or,
I wouldn't say thunderstorm season, but this is the time of year, you know? Have you noticed the people going in the restaurants too?
Can I form close friendships in this town? No. As usual. Friends I have recently on the internet, some of which are on Fly on Wall Fiesta. That's about it, people. That's how it goes for some. Lone Wolf. Buddy Nate. Nate Elder has a Nate. Has a remote control arm control for his car for acceleration, forward, and brake. And then he steers with this hand. Like this. I'm gonna put this in my neck for a second, see if I can get the angle right. Let's hope. Goes like this. He goes, ding, ding. Oh yeah, and there's a knob thing too. He's like this. He drives 110 miles an hour through the California
forest. We were sued in the depositions.
When we were driving there, it looked just like the Oregon coastal range.
We were sued in the depositions. We were sued in the depositions. Cost fear. We were sued.
Enough talk.
We were sued in the depositions. Cost fear.
Slide into a car. We're on the freeway and there was this traffic jam all of a sudden, and we're going like, you know, I don't know, 75 miles an hour, and we just had some bong hits, and so we're kind of in our own zone. Lo and behold, we look up and the car is stopped like right there, 10 feet in front of us. And Nate did a nice power slide maneuver right around it. He's like, perfectly pulled up to the side and stopped. Made a comment about parallel parking to all the people in the car. They looked like they were stoned. Oh, yeah. It was 4:20 too, the day, you know, notorious stoner day in Sebastopol, California, which is a weed haven. And, so they were all stoned looking at us like, what the hell? But Nate had a Go camera right here mounted, you know, a sports camera right here on the dashboard. The damn thing wasn't recording at the time. Still bitter about it. Data setting up part of the carnival rides here. It's a small town, people would just fit. And over in the park, they have bands play, and then downtown, they do something. I'm not into this stuff, really. When I was a kid, I was. Last carnival I went to was in Malibu, California. It was okay, it was kind of interesting, but I didn't really want to be there. I was tired and didn't have money to blow. But I did see Michael Rapaport coming out of the toilets, the porta potties, the honey buckets is what they call them. My favorite brand of porta potty at a festival. And better let these people cross. Oh, maybe they're not turning. Okay. But yeah, Michael Rapaport came out and he was like talking to his kid inside, like, "Are you done yet? Are you done yet, Johnny? Did you finish wiping?" Or whatever, you know. I'm not going to do a New York accent right now. Plus, it's coming out Woody Allen instead of Michael Rapaport. But say less to need. And then he came out of the porta potty and he looked at me like he knew me for a second. And then that was it. And then we left Malibu. And now I'm talking to you about it. Like you give a flying fuck of an ass.
Down there screaming. Cats on the porch eating and stuff.